That is another 5 marks problem. Problem number 9. What is your claim? Your claim is cos A plus cos B by sin A minus sin B whole to the power n plus sin A plus sin B by cos A minus cos B whole to the power n equal to 2 cot to the power n A minus B by 2 or 0. Cot 2 cot to the power n A minus B by 2 when n is even and 0 when n is odd. Okay. N is even means n is even integer, n is odd means n is odd integer. At first, what is your left hand side? Your left hand side is cos A plus cos B by sin A minus sin B whole to the power n plus sin A plus sin B by cos A minus cos B whole to the power n. Okay? At first use cos C plus cos D formula. That is 2 cos C plus D by 2 into cos C minus D by 2 by using sin C minus sin D formula. 2 cos C plus D by 2 into sin C minus D by 2. Okay? Whole to the power n plus. Using sin C plus sin D formula, that is 2 sin C plus D by 2 into cos C minus D by 2 by cos C minus cos D formula, use this formula. That is 2 sin C plus D by 2 into sin D minus C by 2. So, those are very important formulas. Use those formulas. Cancel out 2 and 2. Here 2 and 2. Also cancel out cos A plus B by 2. So, assume cos A plus B by 2 not equal to 0. As well as cancel out sin A plus B by 2. So, sin A plus B by 2 also not equal to 0. So, assume cos A plus B by 2 and sin A plus B by 2 both are non-zero. So, what you get? You get cos A minus B by 2 by sin A minus B by 2. So, that is cot A minus B by 2 whole to the power n. Plus, you have cos A minus B by 2 but sin B minus A by 2. Now, what is sin B minus A by 2? Sin B minus A by 2 means sin minus of A minus B by 2. And you know sin minus theta means minus sin theta. So that is minus of sin A minus B by 2. Clear? So I can write it cos A minus B by 2 by sin A minus B by 2. And you have also a minus. So, you have minus cot A minus B by 2 whole to the power. Sin B minus A by 2 means minus sin A minus B by 2. Cos A minus B by 2 by sin A minus B by 2. That means cot A minus B by 2. And this minus is this. So, what you get? You get cot to the power n A minus B by 2 plus minus 1 whole to the power n into cot to the power n A minus B by 2. Okay? Now, you have two cases. N is even and N is odd. So, at first, if N is even, then minus 1 whole to the power n is plus 1. Because minus 1 whole to the power 2 is plus 1, minus 1 whole to the power 4 is plus 1, minus 1 whole to the power 6 is plus 1. So, your LHS equal to minus 1 whole to the power n is plus 1. So, cot to the power n a minus b by 2 plus cot to the power n a minus b by 2. So, you have 2 cot to the power n a minus b by 2. That is your RHS. And still, if n is odd, if n is odd, n is even means n is even integer, n is odd means n is odd integer, then minus 1 whole to the power n is minus 1, because minus 1 whole to the power 3 is minus 1, minus 1 whole to the power 5 is minus 1. So, LHS equal to cot to the power n a minus b by 2 minus cot to the power n a minus b by 2. So, cancel out these two things. So, you have 0 in your right hand side. So, if n is even integer, then LHS equal to RHS, as well as if n is odd integer, then LHS equal to RHS. So, from these two things, proved my claim. So, that is